Afterward to the Prophet. The office of the prophet is divinely appointed by God, and whom God did predestinate, them he also called. The commission to serve in the area of prophecy requires a complete understanding of each of the preceding chapters, as well as an intense desire to do the will of God. As you accept your high calling to the prophetic, I pray that you will prayerfully contemplate the enormous responsibility that God has placed on your life. Consider the demanding sacrifices that will be asked of you, and reflect upon your personal experiences with God in the area of prophecy. Once you have said yes to God, you will be ready to completely surrender yourself to a place where you can accept as truth all of the contents contained herein. If you are only able to recognize a few chapters as relevant to prophetic ministry, but are sure of your election, then you are not quite ready to go forth. I therefore challenge you to examine yourself, lay before God, and continue seeking His face. After a time of seeking God, He will renew your mind and enlighten your heart. Then you will be able to accept every truth contained in this writing. As a prophet, you must understand that you need God's divine intervention in every area of your life. You must not lean unto your own understanding, but you must always lean and depend on God. Your finite and human understanding will cause you to fall into sin and erroneously speak into the lives of others what God has not instructed you to speak. The words you speak are the words of God, and the effect upon the souls of men are eternal. Understanding who your audience is and how to develop, protect, carry, and serve in your prophetic capacity is vital and should not be taken lightly. The souls of others are depending on the prophet to be circumspect, obedient, and knowledgeable. Prophet of God, you must operate daily from a place of love and humility for God and for the souls of man. You must recognize that God is sovereign and just. You have been blessed with the honor of being able to see into the spirit world, and the gift of discernment has been imparted into your life. I have obeyed God. I have shared with you God's revelation about how to walk in integrity and uprightness of heart. I have shared with you how to be effective in the office of the prophet. I have shared with you some of my personal testimony in the prophetic. Because the Lord has given me a ministry of discipleship, as well as this revelation regarding the office of the prophet, it is vitally important that you recognize that the book you are holding in your hands was written by the divine inspiration and revelation of God Almighty. It is His desire to see all of us walk in the full measure and stature of Christ. Finally, I have attempted to communicate to you how necessary it is for the body of Christ to effectively operate in the apostolic prophetic rhythms of God, and that nothing happens without a sound. Therefore, I speak forth the gifting and calling of God in your life. I pray that it be activated with the full capacity of kingdom authority. You have been given everything that pertains to life and godliness according to the knowledge of Christ. I command you to walk in the authority of the knowledge which you have received without shame, guilt, doubt, and intimidation of men or of the principalities of darkness. I pray this in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen.